Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and with me is Simon Perryman, a senior technical evangelist with Microsoft.
Thanks.
Thanks for being here. So tell us just a quick bit about your background.
Sure. So I've been at Microsoft about 6.5 years. I spent about 4.5 years actually as an engineer on the high availability team in Windows Server.
Okay.
So I got the pleasure of actually designing a lot of the high availability and virtualization technologies, and then also a lot of the integration points around Operations Manager, Virtual Machine Manager.
Mm-hmm.
So when this awesome job came up as a technical evangelist, where you just get to work with a lot of customers, do a lot of customer-facing events, jumped on the opportunity, I've been really happy working with our customers since then.
Well, we're really happy to have you here.
Thanks.
So if I'm an elf in my data center stump, I have a lot of system center experience. Does that mean I can just run right in and take this test?
I would say probably not, unless you have familiarity with all the system center products. So I found these exams very challenging,
mm-hmm.
and I walked into them cold, thinking I would pass. You know, I was good at Virtual Machine Manager, good at Operations Manager.
Yeah.
I'd never touched Service Manager before, and I was pretty new to Orchestrator, and I did not do so hot. And so one thing that I really want to try to encourage people here is don't walk into this exam cold unless you're familiar with all of these components. Because it really does, as you kind of look at those skills measured, it really does break it down and expect you have a lot of competency
sure.
in service delivery, a lot of competency in automation. And so if these are just gaps that you have no knowledge of, you're not going to do too well on them, and you're probably not going to pass the exam. So get some good hands-on experience across all these different components.
And that's bore out by subject matter experts that we've literally flown in from all over the world, folks like yourself,
right.
that tell us what should be on this exam. And so one of the things that this exam focuses on is monitoring stuff. So why is this important, and what exactly does that mean in a private cloud environment?
Sure. So monitoring primarily uses System Center Operations Manager. And then one of the other System Center components that's not quite as well known as System Center Advisor. And so as we kind of think, why is monitoring important? Well, as we've kind of gone through our first exam, hopefully many of you have taken that as well, we've built up our infrastructure, built up our private cloud. But now that we've got our applications and virtual machines running, we want to make sure that they stay healthy. Not just that they're online, but that they're actually performing well as well. And so one of the biggest investments System Center Operations Manager made with this release was better monitoring throughout the stack, from our hardware, our operating system, our guest operating systems, virtual machines, and then applications within them.
Yeah.
In fact, about 2.5 years ago, we purchased a company known as Avicode, took that application monitoring technology and put it inside Operations Manager. So you're going to notice about somewhere between 30-40% of this exam is all around monitoring. How do you configure it, set it up? What types of things can you monitor?
Sure.
Monitoring .NET apps, Java apps. So really a lot of focus on monitoring, just because it's so important to not just have, you know, availability, but have good performance
yep.
and service continuity as well.
Okay, so we have everything monitoring. We have our apps up and running, and they're healthy at the moment. But what happens if our data center stump burns down? What do we do next?
So disaster recovery, that's going to be a pretty big topic as well. As we're really thinking about these private cloud models, private cloud doesn't meet all of our customer needs. If you're a small customer that has maybe 5 servers,
yep.
you're probably not building a private cloud and using System Center, right? So we're really thinking the System Center, this kind of architecture level, as some of our medium to larger customers.
Yep.
And now we're also really trying to think about using disaster recovery as well. It's kind of a critical learning concept. Backing up our data with Data Protection Manager, making sure it's available in multiple locations. And so you're going to see kind of a few questions on here looking about multiple sites. So how would you go architect Virtual Machine Manager or Operations Manager when you have multiple data centers? How do you configure the trust relationship? What if they're in a DMZ or kind of an external zone? So really understanding how the pieces connect to provide and support that monitoring, important in part because of that whole focus on the backup and recovery.
Yeah. You know, one thing you mentioned earlier was automation. So what components are involved in automation, and what exactly are we automating?
Well, good question. I think the answer to that is everything.
Yeah.
So that's really our goal here. Now, as far as automation goes, our primary component is System Center Orchestrator.
Okay.
One of the new components in System Center 2012, and that actually came from an acquisition as well of a company known as Opalis. So bought the company, built the product, and then integrated it with our other System Center components. The second key automation one is going to be using System Center Service Manager. Now, Service Manager is generally considered kind of our help desk tool, but it actually ties together a lot of the other System Center components. So you can get alerts, And based on the alert, you can go trigger automation.
Okay.
And so really the key thing we're thinking about automation is freeing up time for our IT pros. These repetitive tasks, figure out what they are, automate them, free up your time so you're no longer doing them throughout the, you know, life cycle of an application or the data center.
So you said we have an alert, it triggers some sort of automation. Can you give me an example of what that would be? Because I think as an IT guy, that's awesome that I don't have to run into the office and reset a server or whatever.
Absolutely. Well, you know, a lot of people say, hey, why is this automation even needed if I have high availability? And so as we kind of think, what's high availability, and then how do we go take it this next step? Well, with high availability, we're really restarting applications or virtual machines. But in many cases, applications are more complicated than just a single VM that crashes. Mm-hmm. It's this multi-tiered set of virtual machines, front-end web tiers, back-end databases. And then it maybe has dedicated storage arrays, a load balancer. And so we can't just reset that entire solution. Right? It's not just a single VM. And so as we're really thinking about having this end-to-end continuity, we're really thinking about how we can tie all the system center components together. So a good example would be you use Operations Manager to monitor the health of the service. And so that would be your virtual machines, the applications, the host that they are running on, the associated networking component, and then your storage as well, even making sure you have capacity on your SANs.
Yeah.
When there's a problem there, it can go trigger an alert. Service Manager can inventory that. And, you know, even if we can fix something automatically, it's important that we document it so our help desk can go, take a look at this. The end of the month, what components were the faultiest? What components might need to be refreshed in our next cycle? So by using Service Manager, we get that visibility in what's happening in the data center as well. And then finally, Orchestrator. This component at the end that has these runbooks, the workflows. We get an alert, we inventory it, we go trigger Orchestrator, and Orchestrator will programmatically fix it. Fully automated, end-to-end, so long as it's a repetitive series of steps. You know, that's what we're going for. Find the repetitive stuff, build that automation around it.
Well, and you mentioned Runbook. I think that's a really cool technology that we test on. Can you talk just a little bit about what is that?
Absolutely. So a Runbook is basically a collection of automatic activities that Orchestrator can go and execute. And the best way you can visualize it is actually thinking of a Visio diagram, where you kind of have a starting point, you have an endpoint, and then you have some activities in between that go and really connect the dots. So an example might be, instead of kind of doing a repetitive onboarding process from Active Directory, where you get an email from human resources, copy and paste into the different objects in AD, what we could do is provide a form for our human resources department, a web page. They fill it out, say, first name, last name, domain, what their email address will be. Then they can click submit. And so what we're providing then is they click submit, we capture that information, take those different pieces as different parameters, and then we can automatically go create those objects in AD. And so this is also a great example of private cloud because we're providing self-service for the human resources filling out the form themselves. We have automation, because it's doing that repetitive task of first name, last name, domain.
Yep.
And it's freeing up our IT department's time. So great example of private cloud and showing how these different pieces connect.
Well, thanks so much for being here, Simon. It really helps explain what we're testing on, what we're trying to think about for 70-246, monitoring and operating a private cloud with System Center 2012, which is one of the exams in the MCSC for private cloud. So thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me. And as a final reminder, if you're looking to get more content, better practice, education around this, take the mock exams from Microsoft Learning or the mock curriculum. Great way to spend a full week really going into the technology. And also check out the Microsoft Virtual Academy, www.microsoftvirtualacademy.com. Lots of great free online training for you there as well. Well, with that, thanks for having me again, and good luck with your exams.